Doesn't kill you, makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes you fighter. Footsteps even lighter. Doesn't mean I'm over, 'cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, stronger. Just me, myself, and I. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Guys, it's Diabetic Girl, and welcome to the Beaties Rant. So I have done two videos like this before, actually. Things parents don't understand about diabetes, and how to help your parents understand your diabetes. Recently, when I was at camp a couple weekends ago, we talked about siblings and diabetes. So today is sometimes what your siblings may or may not understand, and how to help them understand. So as you guys know, I have a younger sister who is a reasonable amount younger than I am, and has grown up with the diabetes being in the household her entire life. So she has been through a lot in the past. How old are you? 10 years. So sometimes I find that a lot of the problem with younger siblings, especially older siblings are usually okay, but with younger siblings, they kind of, even though they grow up with it around them and in the house with them, they don't always understand what's going on. And it's not like we stop and take the time to actually explain what's going on. We just kind of expect them to pick up on what's going on and deal with it. Well, how is that fair? It's only setting them up for failure. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, you could be giving a shot or something, and they could be asking what's going on, and you don't say anything because you're like, oh, it's just my diabetes. That they've grown up with it. It's fine. Well, then, that's going to backfire at some point in time because the kid's not going to understand what's going on. And, you know, a lot of fears in young children is that the diabetes is contagious. My sister still has that fear, and she's lived in this house for 10 years, you know, because they don't understand the whole, you're not going to catch it. And that's why it is so, so important to drill it into their heads and make sure they understand. You know, you don't just pass by on that one. You just let them understand flat out, and it should be okay. I mean, it's, yes, I get it. For you diabetics watching this and are like, it's diabetic girl, it's so hard. I totally get it, okay? Mine can go command control freak on my diabetes sometimes, which is hard, and I get it. Because, you know, sometimes she doesn't understand what she's saying, and it's frustrating, and it's like, I have the diabetes. My mom should be going command control freak on me, not you. But you want to have that piece where they're involved. They want to help you, you know? Especially if they're younger, they're looking up to you. And, you know, the way you live your life is what they see every single day. And it's like you have to set a good example for them. And, you know, they just want to make sure you're safe too. I mean, provided, I'm sure my sister doesn't know half of what she's saying. I could be wrong. Oh, she's listening because she just turned off her music. I mean, I could be wrong, but at the same time, too, it's like when they grow up with it at such a young age and they don't know what's going on, you know, it's going to lead to questions. Answer those questions. Don't just let them, you know, oh, sorry, I got like the tag. Don't just let them, you know, not know anything. You know, put them in on it. Let them know. Let them see that you're not going to get hurt and that you're okay. You know, take that sort of caution off of them. And I feel like, honestly, they'll be so much happier. And, you know, if they do the occasional remind you to bolus, you know, just say, thanks, I've already done it. Or, you know, I flip out. Don't be like me. Don't flip out. They're just trying to help you. And it can be the sweetest thing. I mean, when I was at camp and we were talking about this, I have to say I'm very 50-50. Sometimes I want her to help and sometimes I don't. You know, because sometimes she's just 10. It's not something she should be involved in, you know? I had it at 10, and I know what my life was like at 10. And I would never, you know, wish that on anyone, you know? I love my diabetes, but I would never, ever wish this on anyone. Ever. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, I feel like, you know, where we are, such role models to younger kids. You know, especially your siblings, people in your neighborhood, in your school, just be open with them. It's not even a problem. Like, I mean, it's not a problem for me. Like, I'm very open, you know? And that's kind of the whole purpose of this is... Is you okay, girl?
Yeah, I fell.
Okay, girl. You know, sorry, she fell. But it's like, you just gotta open them up and let them in, you know? You can't... Okay, this guy's not really stupid. So, for you guys who've seen Frozen, Anna and Elsa, let's talk about this. So, if Elsa has diabetes, that's what we'll go with, instead of her snow power, she has diabetes. So she locks Anna out. So Anna has no idea what's going on. It just makes Anna upset and it makes everything awkward because she doesn't know how to approach her sister. If you do that to your younger sibling, they're not going to know how to approach you when they have questions. And it's just going to lead to chaos and stress, and it's not worth it. So, moral of the story, don't be like Elsa. Can you imagine what that song would be like if you had diabetes? Like, don't let them in, don't let them see. Have the good blood sugar you've always needed to have. That just happened, guys. That just happened. Woo! So I hope you guys enjoyed the live stream, and I am really sorry that I didn't live stream. The studio I was in that day was having some problems with it. They spent almost all day on the phone with YouTube, and it just was not working. So they definitely promised by March 20th, which is the next episode, it should be up and running. And if not, we're just going to call them studio sessions if they're not up and running. So I do apologize for that. I hope this rant was kind of helpful. It was kind of short. Sorry, guys. I have to get back to doing homework and other stuff. So I will talk to you guys later, and here's to year 16. Bye!